Biology.
So very much welcome to this class, whereby in this class we are going to discuss about allergic reaction. So we see that an allergy is a hypersensitive reaction to an antigen by the body. So they result when there is a reaction between an antigen and an antibody, which mainly causes the cell to rupture, releasing histamine chemical. So histamine increases the permeability of the cell, making them take up fluid and eventually to swell. So this may lead to a condition which is called anaphylaxis, whereby the blood vessels will get dilated, leading to lowering of the blood pressure, which eventually may lead to death. So histamine also induces the inflammatory response and pain. So to minimize the pain, antihistamine drugs are used. Example, we have the cetirizine and we also have the pyridol. So the substances that cause an allergy are called allergens. And examples of the allergens, we have dust, there is pollen grains, there is pus, feather, we also have proteins, and then finally we have motion. So let's look on how, let's see on the mechanism of allergic reaction. So how does the allergic reaction take place? So an allergy mainly begins with the entry of the pathogen in the body. So the immune system then quickly recognizes this intrusion. So after the intrusion, the phagocytes then move and engulf the pathogen, destroying them. Or as well, the lymphocytes may produce different antibodies against the harmful microorganism. So the antibodies produced may bind the pathogens, thereby degenerating them to death, or may bind the pathogens for the phagocytes to come and engulf them to death. So apart from that, let's now look at organ transplant, whereby we see that this is the transfer of an organ from the donor to the recipient. So the tissue of the organ being transferred is known as the graft. An allograft is an organ from a donor whose genetic identity is exactly similar to that of the recipient. Also, we have the xenograft, whereby it's a graft from an animal donor to a human recipient. Let's look at an example. So example is by using the valve from the heart of the pig and transplanting it to the human heart. Also, when an eye from an animal is transplanted to a human being, that will be called a xenograft. So, the recipient body will quickly recognize this as a foreign, and immune rejection will quickly kick in. So, to avoid immune rejection of a graft, tissue typing is done or drugs are administered to suppress the recipient's immune response. But what is tissue typing? So this is the determination of the genetic similarity between the donor and the recipient. So the more closely related they are, the greater the chances of success for the transplant. It should also be noted that immune suppressive drugs administered during grafting may suppress the normal immune response against the pathogens. And this makes the recipient to be susceptible to different environmental diseases. So finally, let's look at the problems associated with organ transplant. So the graft can be rejected by the immune system of the recipient. The graft can fight lymphoid tissues of the recipient, thereby causing abnormal growth of the tissues, or this may also lead to cancer tendencies by the recipient. Finally, the immune suppressive drugs, as we had discussed earlier, may suppress the normal immune response against the pathogens. So let's now meet on the next class as we embark on the next topic. Biology.